Hello and welcome to Nidhi's Creative Zone. How are you all? Today I'm going to share with you yet another air fryer recipe using brinjal. For this here I've taken big size brinjal. Now first you have to wash it and then pat it dry. After that grease the brinjal using oil. After greasing it you have to make several cuts or poke it using the fork or knife. It will help to cook the brinjal evenly and it will help to distribute the heat evenly. So now after poking, now let's start cooking. To prepare this recipe I'm using Ninja air fryer. So first press the button and now press the 1. So because I'm going to use the first basket, place this greased eggplant into the basket. Now select the air fryer function. After select the air fryer function, you will notice it shows the temperature. We need to be set the temperature at 350 degree Fahrenheit for about 15 minutes because the size of the eggplant is big. Once it is done, then I will show you. It's being now 4 seconds left as you have seen here. And now it's done. Now press the stop sign. And now carefully remove the basket. And you have seen it is properly done. You have seen the shrink of the skin. That means it is perfectly done. Now carefully with the help of tongs remove it into the plate. Do it carefully because it is still very hot. Now let it cool down completely. Now here I have taken one medium sized tomato. Make small cut at the bottom. And now grease it with the help of oil. After greasing it with the oil, place this into the air fryer basket. Insert this into the air fryer and now set the temperature at 350 degree Fahrenheit for about 5 minutes and once it is done, I will show you. So now the tomato is also done. As you have seen here, it has started leaving the skin but it is still very hot. Place this into the same plate and now let it cool down completely. It's been 20 minutes, it's completely cooled down. Now carefully remove the skin and you have seen how easily the skin of the tomato came off. Similar way, remove the skin of the brinjal. You have seen it is very easy to remove the skin when you are using the air fryer. Now discard the peel. Now cut it into several smaller pieces so that it will be easier. You can use the mixer also. So you have seen these are the seeds of this. If you don't like it, you can remove it. But in this recipe, we are going to use every part of the brinjal. Now chop the tomato also. And now this is how it looks like. The base of the recipe is ready. Take a pan, put it on the heat. Add 2 teaspoons of oil. You can use mustard oil also. It will go very well with this recipe. Let the oil hot. Once the oil hot, add 3 to 4 garlic cloves, that is chopped. Make sure to use the chopped garlic cloves. It will give a very chewy texture when the recipe is done. Saute it for a couple of seconds. And now add the 1 inch piece of chopped garlic. Saute it for about a minute or so or until it turns aromatic. After that add 1 medium size chopped onion and now you have to saute the onion until the onion became translucent. Once the onion became translucent, as you have seen here, add 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 pinch of asafoetida or hing, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1/4 teaspoon of red chili powder or according to your taste, 2 piece chopped green chilies, and here I have taken 3 tablespoons of fresh green peas. This is totally optional but it will give a very nice flavor and taste. And now saute it. Make sure the heat is on low medium flame at this point. After everything mixed, now cover and cook it for about 1 to 2 minutes on medium flame. After 2 minutes, open the lid and you have seen all the things are properly cooked and the peas are also done. Give it a quick mix. Now add 1 tablespoon of garam masala and 1.5 teaspoon of salt or according to your taste. Give it a quick mix. Garam masala give a very nice taste into the recipe. Now add the peeled eggplant or brinjal that we have air fried, and tomato we are going to add little later. And now mix everything, and once everything is mixed, as you have seen here, spread it evenly and now cover and cook it for about 2 to 3 minutes on medium flame. Then I will show you. After 3 minutes you have seen it's almost done, and when you are pressing it, it will easily break out. You have seen here, I will show you the closure view. This is how it looks like. We are looking for this type of consistency. Either you can use the spatula or the potato masher. We have to smash it. And now add the tomato inside that and give it a quick mix. Once you have added the tomato, you will notice it will start leaving the water. Now you have to cover it for about another 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, you will notice this is how the recipe looks like. And now give it a quick mix and again saute it for about a minute or so while stirring in between. And if there is any big chunk pieces, you have to smash it. After that, add handful of cilantro. It will give a nice flavor and recipe. Give it a quick mix and switch off the gas at this point. And the delicious bangan bharta is ready to serve. It is so yummy and tempting. Here I have served it into the bowl. It is ready to serve. Serve hot with some puris or paratha according to your choice. Here I have served it with puris. While cooking this bangan bharta, make sure when you are frying the brinjal, it needs to be properly cooked from inside so that it will give a nice smoky flavor. If you like this recipe of bangan bharta using air fryer, then don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe. Thank you. Thanks for watching.